At the end of World War II, the world witnessed the rapid emergence of newly independent countries, unshackling themselves from the clutches of weakening colonial powers. Bharat finally obtained its independence on August 15, 1947. Although this independence came after a painful and horrific partition of Hindus' historic and spiritual homeland, the world witnessed one of the largest migrations and mass slaughter of people ever seen in recorded history. The overwhelming majority of Hindu population was driven out of West and East Pakistan, which is now Bangladesh. Hindus all over the world were facing serious threats to their right to exist. Problems were particularly acute in Pakistan and Bangladesh, where Hindus suffered numerous instances of mass genocide, forcible displacement, and conversion. Hindus living in other parts of the world, such as Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Indonesia, the Caribbean islands, Africa, Fiji, were facing discrimination and humiliation, largely on account of their Hindu identity. There was neither a government nor an organization worldwide to effectively look after the interests of Hindus. It was in this context that Hindus from different backgrounds had decided to form an organization to strengthen Hindu society throughout the world. Prominent and respected Hindu leaders such as Swami Chinmayananda Saraswati, Sri M.S. Golwalkar, Sri Shivram Shankar Apte, Sardar Master Tara Singh, Jain Muni Sushil Kumar, and all the assembled leaders on August 29, 1964, on the day of Krishna Janmashtami, finally formed the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. Over the past 46 years, Vishwa Hindu Parishad has served Hindu society with great effort. The most prominent example of VHP's contribution to the Hindu resurgence was during Sri Ram Janmabhoomi movement, which was the monumental agitation by Hindus demanding the restoration of the holy site of the birthplace of Bhagwan Ram to Hindu society. Our forefathers have worked hard to nourish and preserve Hindu society. Other societies which were ruled by either imperialistic, Islamic or Christian forces failed to retain their native religious traditions and instead were converted to the religions of their conquerors. Hindu society, however, in the subcontinent, valiantly resisted over a period of 1200 years. Currently, Hindus are facing serious challenges and are being attacked from all directions in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Indonesia, Europe, Africa, America, the Caribbean, and Fiji. In Bharat, Hindus continue to face disadvantage and discrimination vis-a-vis other communities. Given this scenario that confronts Hindus, it is necessary to assemble once again. Now is the time for the present generation of Hindus to take this valiant legacy forward and to assume the implied responsibility of shaping and nurturing Hindu unity and organization throughout the world. The World Hindu Foundation proposes to organize the first World Hindu Congress in the year 2014. Features of the first World Hindu Congress. The theme envisioned is the Hindu principle of Sangachadvam Samvadadvam, which means step together, express together. With the guiding principle and as our inspiration, there will be several conferences held during the Congress. Hindu Youth Conference, conducted by the Hindu Students and Youth Network with the theme of harnessing the dynamic spirit and energy of Hindu youth by shaping the next generation of leaders of the Hindu resurgence. Hindu Economic Conference, conducted by the World Hindu Economic Forum with the theme of shaping the world economy along with making Hindu society prosperous so that it can decisively influence the world economy. Hindu Political Conference, conducted by the World Hindu Democratic Forum with the theme of encouraging Hindus to ascend to the highest levels of the political process. Hindu Educational Conference, conducted by the Hindu Education Board with the theme that education will be instrumental for the Hindu reawakening and revival. The conference will bring together the top experts and experienced officials in the field of education who can pool their expertise and experience to develop strategies to provide quality and well-rounded education to all members of the Hindu society. Hindu Organizational Conference, conducted by the Hindu Organizations, Temples and Associations Forum, the HOTA Forum, with the guiding theme of Sange Shakti Kaliyuge, organization is strength. The primary goal is to provide a platform for the Hindu organizations, associations and institutions that are nobly working to serve Hindu society in their individual capacities. Hindu Women Conference, conducted by Hindu Women Forum, inspired by the theme of increasing the role of women in the Hindu Renaissance. The conference aims to come up with strategies of how Hindu women can be at the forefront of the Hindu Renaissance and Resurgence. Hindu Media Conference, conducted by the Hindu Media Forum, guided by the theme of establishing a robust Hindu presence in all forms of the media. A satirical quote from the James Bond movie Tomorrow Never Dies sets the tone of the new world order. The power-hungry villain in the movie, Elliot Carver, who was a media mogul bent upon world domination, said that Caesar had his legions, Napoleon had his armies, I have my divisions, TV, news, magazines, and by midnight tonight, I'll have reached and influenced more people than anybody in the history of this planet, save God Himself. Delegates should be committed to working for the Hindu resurgence. Delegates should be from the ranks of activists, academicians, industrialists, businessmen, parliamentarians, legislators, media personalities, leaders, and representatives of various Hindu organizations and institutions. While the first World Hindu Congress will be primarily organized by the World Hindu Foundation, all Hindu organizations, associations, and institutions are encouraged to participate and are most welcome to become partners in making this event a great success.